Hey everybody, welcome back to a short episode of Gavinsky's Tutorials. Today is a follow-up to my video of a few weeks ago on NoiseSpace by Igor Vasiliev, this really cool app for making soundscapes that works on Mac and iPad and iPhone, standalone or as an AUv3 plugin. That video was a detailed walkthrough on the app. In this video, I'm just going to look at a couple of the main features of the new update that just came out, the first important update to the app. And it's a really good update. So in the original version of the app, you could process external audio, right? So here we have this external audio coming in from Fundamental 2. You could process external audio to some extent, but it was limited. So now we have more options for processing external audio. That is the main thing about this update. And there are two things that have been added. And so the first one is that in the original, these are the options for processing input. In the original, you could have that off, so it wouldn't process external input. It would use noise generated inside the app and then shape that noise. But in the original version, we had two options. We had this one, DST G1 and DST G1 G2. Now we have a new option, DST All. So this is the first thing I'm going to talk about. So in the original version, if you chose this, as I say, you only had these two options. If you chose this, you were sending the stereo signal from the input to generator one. If you chose this, you were sending the left channel of the input to generator one and the right channel to generator two. And you couldn't send anything to generator three, four, or five. They could just use the app's own internally generated noise and then do some granular processing and other stuff to that. But so now we have this option, DST All. And so that allows you to send the input, external input, to all of the generators. It'll send a stereo input to each generator. So if we just even listen into that. Now here, we're actually only hearing background. If you remember from my original walkthrough, this generates two layers, the main layer and the background layer. Here, the knob is in the middle, which means it can, in theory, output both. But I have all the level knobs down here, so we're only hearing the background. But even here, we can hear the difference that the new update makes, because if I, say, set it like this, here, you know, we're only getting that external input going to those two generators. And you can hear that now when we change it to all, we're just getting this much richer sound. There's a lot more going on there. But now let's look at the really big thing. So as I mentioned earlier, in the original version, you could not use these tone knobs to actually shape the external input. You could only use some of the stuff related to the filters and the background settings and so on. But now what we can do, if we set the filter input type in this section, if we set that to input modulation, what that will do is it will use this waveform here that the generator is outputting. It'll use that to modulate the input signal. So let's have a listen to that. So first I'm going to solo. Okay, generator one. And I think I'll leave it with the background mixed in, fine. So now I am going to click here. And we've already set this to input modulation. Actually, first thing I'm going to do is turn up the level here. Okay, so now let's click again on main. And now I'm going to play with these tone knobs, and you'll see that they will change the sound. And they didn't do that in the original version. Right? So this is this kind of like experimental ring mod type, similar to that in some ways. Now if I bring that level knob down, now we have no background. So we can also change here with change the filter into like the modulation amount and the gating, all stuff that I explained in my video. Let's turn that gating up. Okay, let's hear that. We need to turn that modulation amount up. Right, if that's down, playing with these won't make any difference. So, I'm really glad that got added. I'm not saying this is the best, you know, particular example of that. I just want to show that you can do that. Now, I gotta go and experiment with it more, and so can you. This is what it sounds like with all of these set up, with the filter set to input modulation type, but some differences in the settings for the tone generators and stuff. Look at the differences in the waveforms, right? And so this is with no background. And here, bringing in the background. And here we got mostly background and just a little bit of level. This is much more sort of soundscapey. Great. All right, everyone. Hope this was useful for you. If it was, please smash the like, etc. Note, by the way, a few weeks ago, also on Patreon, I put up a detailed video, maybe 20 minutes long, 30 minutes long, maybe, can't remember, on some tips on preset, you know, designing your own presets in NoiseSpace. There's a lot of good stuff on my Patreon. Highly recommend you check it out if you haven't. I need the support, and patrons get a lot in return. Thank you, everyone. Oh, and also, I put out a post in the community the other day, you know, just reminding people about, like, how useful affiliate links are as a way to support people like me working in this niche where we have no Apple App Store affiliate links, which has destroyed the YouTube scene because nobody doing YouTube in this space can really make any proper money from that anymore. So I put, you know, my links, and you'll always find those in the pinned comments, links for Plugin Boutique, Audiomodern, and so on and so on. If you're buying desktop stuff, you can use those, doesn't cost you anything, and it helps me actually get a bit of money back for all the time that I put into this stuff. So yeah, when I put that post up the other day, I got a few emails, you know, coming in. Oh, you know, you got a sale on DMT, Cymatics, Gumroad or whatever, or, you know, some Plugin Boutique notifications and stuff. So thank you, everyone. I mean, I know it gets very tedious, by the way, listening to YouTubers like going on and on about, you know, support me. But if we don't mention it, people just don't do it. You know, they just forget. So thank you for your patience. And thank you especially to those people who actually do listen to what I say and care and do try and support in some way. Thank you, guys. All right, take it easy. Bye-bye.